All right, so what's job number one? We are stripping back to stone. Yep, so there's still two walls in there that have the old cladding on. I need to get that off and then get it monocouched. I am just thrilled. I'm super excited because this week we're getting into something that feels like it is finally additive. It is construction. It's not just demolition. Even putting in the new ceiling beam was technically construction, but that was only so that we could demolish a wall. This week we're getting into the monocouching, so we're going to be rendering over all of the walls in what will be the living room. But before we can monocouche, I need to clear off the walls. I'm going to use the air compressor to blow the dust off them because it is dusty in there. It's a bit like the Wild West. When you watch the videos of people doing monocouche, and I've seen a few now, it just seems to go on smooth and it sticks. When I do it, it just seems to fall off really smooth. If anybody watching knows what I'm doing wrong, please tell me.
So, I made a bit of progress and it's looking a lot better now. In the end, what I did was just went at it with a much smaller trowel so that I could actually get on that first light coat all around the different sort of bricks that were very lumpy, and that's what wasn't working. I couldn't get in there with the bigger trowel. So this is just the very first coat, so it doesn't need to be super smooth.
Is this what you could have sprayed on?
Yeah, like you either get a real hardcore heavy duty sprayer, in which case this would all be a breeze, but we can't afford that. Or you get like this little putsy thing that's like... So I'll figure it out. It's working, you know, it's getting there. We'll be alright.
It looks good though.
Yeah, it's come up fine.
It looks way better than before. I feel like so much better. That's sealed in. We're not just gonna plasterboard over a crumbling mess.
So it's smooth and it looks a lot better than it did, but it's not picture perfect. But it doesn't have to be. This wall was all clad in timber, and when we took all the timber off, this section had basically fallen down and crumbled, which happens over time with the stone walls. All the mortar breaks away, and once the mortar's gone, the rocks go. So that's the whole reason that we're putting on this monocouche. It's not the finished layer, it's not what you're gonna see when it's done. So it will keep all of the wall together so that once we clad it, it's not gonna fall down behind our plasterboard.
When we bought this house, the previous owner used to tell us that apparently there was treasure that had been left here by the guy who owned it before him, who went a bit mad. And if you look really closely in this hole, you see that it's not here. There's just broken glass and bits of cement. No treasure though.
What now then?
On to the next one.
Can I even look up?
It's just over here, babe.
Oh! What is it? Lift with your back?
Lift with your back. It's strung like a crane.
Ooh,
boom! Might be a bit wet, hey?
It's a bit wet.
Is it a bit wet, do you reckon?
It's a bit wet.
Let's fix? Should we fix the mix?
Yeah. We are pushing this bucket to the limits.
So if the mortar doesn't fit, you either have too much mortar or not enough bucket.
If you're using mortar,
you're doing it wrong.
You're not going to believe this.
It's too dry now.
Yeah.
Should we measure potentially? Like, so is there a recipe for this?
There is a recipe. The recipe says
4 to 5 liters per bag. It's just give or take 20 to 25%. It's just a small margin of error.
Well, you got both margins. Pretty good. Too wet?
My legs or the bucket?
Go on, mix it now.
I'm pretty unimpressed with that.
She's Goldilocks. I don't know how to do that. That's not it.
How do you feel about it?
Were you this slow?
I'm a little bit faster than you.
Hiya.
Becca has a competitive side. You want to race? I'll time you to do a square meter.
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay.
All right.
We have to measure it.
Yeah. Oh, no, don't worry. It's going to be very official.
When did you become a professional monocouche? Just now, eh? I would like to hire you for the rest of this walk.
Hire me?
Yeah, I can pay you.
You can definitely see. Yeah.
No, I don't stand a chance. I don't have the upper body strength for this like you do.
Is that my square meter?
I'd say that's your square meter done.
But I want to see my time. 6 minutes. What does it say?
6 minutes.
What does it say?
You're dreaming.
What does it say?
Well, it says 9 minutes, but...
But what?
I stopped it by mistake.
How many times did you stop it?
Just once.
Why did you
but
stop
you
it?
But you were about halfway through when I realised.
Oh, this is...
Well, look, it says...
Look, my next square meter will be faster.
Oh, I like the sound of that. Go!
So you do yours, and we'll do it properly.
Told you she's competitive.
And then I'll do another square meter.
All right.
Are you ready?
Yeah, I am now. Absolutely. Let's do this.
On your marks. Get set, go.
You know what has never once improved my performance at anything?
Being time?
Time pressure, yeah.
How about being watched? And just the occasional...
Just the occasional critique, maybe. Yeah. Or just sort of, like, indeterminate noises. Like,
just the general...
It's not funny! It's not a monocouche. Had a breakdown. What happened to you?
Oh, you're already on 10 minutes.
And nearly finished.
Are you?
What a super time. You've nearly finished the bucket.
That's because it's all on the floor, babe. Just skip it off the floor.
Well, I'm out of monocouche. What do you want from me?
You want to stop the timer?
I guess, yeah.
17 minutes.
So the outcome of this, right, is whoever is fastest does the rest of the wall because it's the most efficient use of our time?
Yes.
Cool.
Yes. Okay, it is day 2 today and I've sent Jack off to get more monocouche with the kids because I'm going to have a proper go at a timed square meter.
Alrighty, Brico Depot. We're here. Brico Depot! Where is the monocouche?
That's it. That's what you want?
I'm a mixer. Yeah.
That's what I wish we were here for.
Wrong color. round two of the World Monocouche Championships. It is Rebecca Jenkins. In your marks.
Too much time.
Get set and go. Trowels away. It's a lot of hype for quite an anticlimactic start. Dropping it, and you're already at 6 minutes. You tell mummy every time she drops them. All right, 12 minutes and 3 seconds.
Woo!
Becca's in bed, and I am making her a trophy because she won the monocouche competition.
It's with great pleasure that I award you the first annual monocouche trophy. You get gold because you were the fastest.
What the hell am I going to do with this now?
Monocouche!
Did you get a perfectly good trowel and spray it gold?
Yes.
Oh, I'm honoured. That's so funny.
You earned it, baby. Proud of you.
We need to finish that wall now.
All the mortar is sealed in, nice. It's breathable, it's flexible, it's exactly what we need.
Done.
Definitely.
We done?
We're done. That's it. Renovation complete. Check.
Thanks for watching. See you next Sunday when things really get going. Oh my goodness, it's enormous.
Tell me when.
When?
What?
When?
You mean go?
Yes.
I didn't say when.
I want my action scene.
Well, do some action then.
That was it.
Sort of.
What the heck? How do you do it? Oh my god.
There you go, you're using the right side of the trowel now.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
And yet you give a lot of advice.
Oh, I wasn't recording any of it.